Hello and welcome back to another tutorial video. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to use an amazing tool called LinkTree to get all of your links in one place. So if you're a business owner, a YouTuber, a creator, anything, personal, whatever, you have all of these links, your Facebook account, your Twitter account, maybe your TikTok account, your Twitch, your YouTube, any links, your personal website, whatever it may be, LinkedIn, Patreon, anything like that. You have all of these links all over the internet, but by utilizing LinkTree, you are going to be able to put them all in one place. Now, I will say this, I am not sponsored by LinkTree. I don't even know who the developers are. I just find it to be an amazing tool. And if you look here, let's look at Gary V's. If we go to his LinkTree kind of little URL here, you can see he has his podcast, he has his SoundCloud, he has his CastBox, his texting community, and a bunch of other stuff down here at the bottom, like his Twitch and YouTube and all of that stuff. All of these links are in one place. You send the person to your LinkTree URL, and then they are able to find all of your other links within this one nice, tightly knit little link here on LinkTree. So go to linktr.ee. I will highlight it up here in the upper left-hand corner, and I will also put it in the description of this video. Next, you want to go up to the green sign up for free button in the upper right hand corner. Once you do that, you will then need to provide them with an email, a username and a password that you want to use. Accept this here and then go to sign up with email. Once you've inserted your information, go ahead and click on the sign up with email button there. Next, it's going to ask you to confirm a couple of things. You need to type in your full name and then select three tags of categories that will best describe what you will be using your LinkTree for. And so for me, it is branding, influencer, and podcasting and radio. I'm a content creator, YouTuber, influencer, podcaster, and I want to use it to grow my brand. Don't worry too much about this. This isn't really have anything to do with your LinkTree. It just kind of lets them know a little bit more about kind of what you're going to be doing on the platform. So don't think that you're going to mess something up by selecting the incorrect one here. Next, go ahead and click the continue button at the bottom of this page here. It will then take you to the next step to let you know that they do have a pro plan for $6 a month or forever free account, which is the one that we're going to be doing today. Now, I will say this, I'm not a pro member of LinkTree in any shape or form, but the added benefits do seem nice and I may consider it at a later date. You can look into here and see all of the things that a paid account gets that a free one does not. Like link scheduling, priority links, newsletter email signups, which is pretty cool. And then there's some other stuff down here as well, like statistics are different. If you're a free member, you only get totals only. But if you are a premium member, you get daily, weekly, and totals. And if you are a creator like me, that type of data insight would be very valuable. All right, so go ahead and go to sign up for free in the upper right-hand corner. Once you're ready, go to continue to my LinkTree. And this is where all of the magic happens. This is your LinkTree home page. I'm going to go ahead and add a new one to show you how to do it, and then we'll add a few more and then go from there. So the first thing that you want to do is go to add new link. So go to add new link here. And then once you're ready, you're going to give this link a title. So we can hit the little pencil icon there. We're going to go ahead and title this Follow Me on Twitter. Then open up a new tab on your browser. Go to your Twitter profile like I've done here. Copy your Twitter profile by right-clicking and copying or Control or Command C, and then go back to LinkTree and then go ahead and where it says URL, go ahead and click the pencil icon once more and then paste that URL right here where it wants you to. And then when you're done, you just kind of click off there. And then as you can see over here on the right, this is what it's going to look like. So you have your username here, and then you have your kind of channel icon here, and then you have all of your links below that there. Now, the couple of options that you can do for your links, you can add images, you can favorite a link, you can schedule, or you can see the statistics. Again, some of these may not be available to free members, but again, if you are a free member, you can add all the links you want, so don't worry about that. Now, if we want to add another link, it's as simple as going to add new link here, and then going and adding a title and a URL, and you're good to go. I'm going to add a few more, and then I'm going to show you what it looks like once you have a few links added to your LinkTree. All right, I've now added a few more links here to my Linktree, and as you can see, I have one that says listen to my podcast, I have one that says subscribe to my YouTube channel, and then one that says follow me on Twitter. So if I wanted to move these around, if I'm like, I want my YouTube link to be above my podcast link, I can click the three dots over on the left-hand side here and drag that link exactly where I want it in the stack here on my Linktree. Next, you're going to see something in the upper left-hand corner that says appearance. If we click on the appearance tab here, we will see that we have some themes here that we can use. Some are for pro members, but there's a lot of them for free members. I'm going to go ahead and select the mint theme here. And then once I do that, you can see it looks completely different over here. And then as you can tell, we can add a profile title. So if we want to change that here, we can change our image, and then we can also change our bio. So I'm going to go ahead and add an image and a bio, and then once I've done that, I'll show you exactly what that looks like. As you can see, I've uploaded my profile image as well as a very short and brief bio here, selected my theme, and then once I've done all of that, you can see now if I click on my Linktree link here in the upper right-hand corner, you can see now I have all of my links down below, my bio, my profile image, and my username. And all of this was set up in my Linktree settings. Now, there are a couple of other things that you can do, obviously, by going to settings here. If you are a pro member, you can choose to have email signups, SMS signups. You can even add payment providers. Again, this is very beneficial for entrepreneurs, people trying to kind of keep everything in one place. And then if we go down here in the lower left-hand corner, you can see that we have our account and logout options here. Go to My Account. This will allow you to change the appearance settings links all from here, reset your password, or delete the account if that's something that you want to do. But once you are done, go back to the home option here, and you can see now you can just share this link anywhere on the internet, like put that in the description of your YouTube videos or your podcast or whatever it may be, and then allow people to go to your Linktree home or hub, and then they'll be able to follow you on Twitter, listen to your podcast, whatever you want them to do, wherever you want to send them, it can all be done here within Linktree. Again, that's linktr.ee. A great little tool that you can either pay for or get for free. It's a great option for people looking to kind of consolidate all of their links. If you have any questions, please put those in the comment section below. Don't forget, if this video helped you out, don't forget to help me out by liking, sharing, and subscribing to the channel. And I will see you guys in the next video.